Hello everyone, in this video we are going to see how to create tables in HTML. To start with, we'll first have a small introduction about what is HTML, followed by some basic tags that are used for the creation of tables. This is the basic definition of HTML. HTML stands for Hypertext Markup Language. It is a set of markup symbols or codes that are inserted in a file for displaying in a web page. In simple words, HTML is used for designing your web page. This is the skeleton code for HTML. In the beginning, we have a HTML tag. This indicates that the web page is written in HTML language. After this, we have a tag called as head tag. The head tag contains the information about the web. Inside this head tag, we have a tag called as title tag. As the name implies, the title tag contains the web page title. After all these tags, we have a tag called as body tag. The body tag contains the contents of the web page. And at the end, we have a HTML tag preceded by a slash symbol. This marks the end of the web page. Some basic tags that are used in HTML. As I said before, the title tag defines a title for the body. The body tag defines the document's body. Now we'll quickly move on to the other tags. BR is a tag which is used for breaking the line. Similarly, to display your text in different formats, you can make use of this bold, italics and underline tags. To change your font settings, you will make use of this font tag, and for creating tables, you are in need of this table tag. Tables in HTML. For creating tables in HTML, you are in need of these three tags. They are TH, TR and TD. TH represents table header, TR represents table row and TD represents table data. This is the example which I have taken. I am going to write a HTML code for displaying this table. So I want my name, age, gender and male to be as a header for this table. So I am going to give those attributes with the help of my TH tag. And for creating rows, I am going to use my TR tag. And for inserting values inside my table, I am going to use my TD tag. Start with the coding part. I am using my notepad. And in the beginning, I am giving my HTML tag. Don't forget to close your tags. Inside my HTML tag, I'm going to give my body tag. So, I'm going to give the contents of my web page inside this body tag. First, I'm going to create my table with the height 100, width 100 and border 5. You can give any values for these attributes. So I'm going to first create a row. So as we see in the PPT, I want my name, age, gender and male to be a header for this table. So using my TH tag, I'm going to give those values. Name, age, gender and finally the male. So after giving all these things, I'm closing my row. So this implies my first row is created. After creating my first row, I'm going to create my second row. Again, I'm opening my tr tag. So I'm going to give my data in a different color. So since I'm going to give the data inside the table, I'm using my td tag, and I want the background color for the data to be pink. So you can give that with the help of bg color. And similarly, I want my font color to be in blue. So you can give that with the help of a font tag. And I'm randomly giving some values inside my table. And I'm closing my font tag and my td tag. I'm giving the value of age as 19, gender as female, so I'm closing my tr tag. So we are done with it. I'm going to save my file as table.html. Don't forget to give the extension .html. So my file is saved here. So if I just double click it, my table will be displayed. So as I said, my data are inserted inside the table with the background color pink and the font is blue color. So now we'll see some more attributes of table, which is cell padding, cell spacing, row span and call span. Cell spacing sets the space between the cells. Similarly, cell padding sets the space between the cell wall and the cell content. I've given the syntax for cell spacing and cell padding here. Each rectangular box represents the cell, and the space between the cell content and the cell wall is given by cell spacing, and the space between the cells are given with the help of cell spacing. Row span and call span. Row span is used to merge the rows and call span is used to merge the columns. So now I'm going to write a HTML code for displaying this table. In this table, I have my header has name and marks, and in my header marks I have merged two columns together. Similarly, I have given my value as ABC, and in this row I have merged three rows together. I am going to achieve this structure with the help of row span and call span. I have already created a skeleton code for this. All the tags which I have used here are familiar to us. I created my table with height 100, width 100, border as 5, cell spacing value as 5 and cell padding value as 10. So my first header is going to be name and marks. And in my marks header, I have merged two columns together. So in my marks header, I have given my call span value as 2. So this will merge two columns together. And similarly, in my second row, my value is going to be ABC, and here I am going to merge three rows together. So my value is going to be ABC, and I am going to merge three rows together. And similarly, in my first row itself, I have two more values, which are X and P. So I'm done with my first header and my first row. So I'm going to give my other values yq and zr. So I'm done with the coding. I'm going to save this as table2.html. So if I just double click it, you can able to see the table with cell spacing, cell padding and merging of rows and columns. Thank you so much for watching.